Hello everyone, and welcome to DrupalCon Amsterdam 2019 session titled Digital Transformation of Customer Self-Care in a Developing Country. And thank you for choosing this session. I'm Faiyaz, Sheikh Faiyaz Moorsalin. I'm from Bangladesh. It's a developing country in South Asia. Currently, I'm employed at Ergo Ventures as a head of operations. I look after most of the outsourced project in all aspects, like planning, development, deployment, and also managing a team of 12 Drupal developers. I'm working with Drupal Tech for 8 years now, and I've been involved and completed around 20 projects in Drupal across the globe. And I've done my bachelor's in computer science and engineering. So the project of today's case study is one of our prominent project in Drupal. We started working in this telco client from 2010, and frequently updating in terms of design features to generate revenue growth through the website. So let's take a look at the key points of the session. First, we'll talk about the goal, challenges, and the steps we took to overcome the challenges, followed by design evolution and few self-care modules, and also the e-commerce modules. So the goal of this project was to provide self-care features to existing customers and display product and services to the new customers to engage new people into the subscribers, and also to cater the B2B retailers. There are currently 6,000 retailers nationwide. They use this platform to do certain business tasks, and also provide business insights for the researchers with financial facts and information to the investors. The challenges of this project, considering in a developing country, is that the customer base is very large. Currently, they have more than 50 million active subscribers. Among them, we have daily visitors of 150,000. And during the peak hours, it scale up to 5,000 to 6,000 concurrent users. And also, very small percentage of users are tech savvy, and they are aware of the global UX trends. And most of the people are not comfortable with paying online. And about the overcoming these challenges, we developed the site in bilingual content. So we provide English and also in the local language, which is Bangla. And we have introduced a distraction-free conversion funnel, where we take the user into multiple steps to activate particular bundles or any services. And we remove all the sidebars and highlight sticky things. And we simplified the information architecture to find out the information very quickly and easily. And also we integrated a live chat, which is integrated with the CRM. So whenever a customer is facing any problem within any steps, so then they can chat with the live agent and get the solution very quickly. So let's start with the design evolution. Since 2010, we have done 4 major design revamps. The first one is back in 2010, where we tried to keep the information architecture very simple, to get any information within 3 clicks. And one of the major goals for that design is it should load in maximum browsers, including Internet Explorer. The second one is the first responsive one, back in 2014. And we also followed a few design guidelines from the organization. In the third one, we integrated shop, the e-commerce one, where users can buy phones, telco devices through online and get delivered into the doors. And the latest version we revamped in 2018. Here we have redesigned the information architecture to be more to provide discoverability and scalability concerns. integrated site-wide sign-in options, single sign-on, and also optimized few major conversion funnels. So the self-care transformations. Before self-care transformation, user the subscribers has to buy packs through USSD code like *121*1#. So it is very difficult to remember which pack activates with which USSD code. And for recharge, they need to physically visit and locate the retailer shops. And also, they can only do the recharging through the retailer's business hour. So those are the difficulties customers used to have. So the most important, the very first self-care features that we have introduced in the site is called the Flexi Plan. It provides an option to the customers so they can choose how many data they want, how many SMS they want, how many talk time they want for a particular validity like 1 day, 7 days, or 15 days and 30 days. So based on the selection, they will have the cost for this pack and also how much money they are saving, considering the other telco providers and the fixed packs. And user can play around all the options, these things. And here we have to reduce the load in the backend server, rather than using an Ajax, we transfer all the data packs, the matrix, into the front end. So whenever a user clicks or changes any option, the pricing and the discounts updates from the local data from the browser. So we used extensive JavaScript here. So once the user have selected a particular pack, they go to the step two, where they get a preview which pack they have selected. Also with an option to upsell, like if you pay few more taka, then you will get 20 minutes and save up to 76%. So it's pushing customer to pay more through the activation. And if it's customer, it's okay with the selected pack, they put in their number, and OTP is sent to their customer's phone number. After putting the OTP, the activation is done, and they get a success page. So the behind the screen, this is the process, how the entire thing works. So first, user gets the available packs with validity from the application, and it fetches from the database, and it's loaded into the front end of the customer, and they play around all the combinations. Once they have selected, they go to the page, and when they're done, we create a custom order ID against that purchase option. We send that OTP against that ID, and when the OTP is given from the customer, we checks with our database that if this is the correct OTP or not. There's a certain time for validation, expiry time. When all this verification is done, we send it to the internal system of the telco's backend, so which we're calling as the CRM. So the ultimate activation is done through the CRM. So once that is done, the CRM sends an SMS, success SMS, to the customer, and also send us feedback back to our application. And based on that, we show the customer that the pack is successfully activated. So there is another case in this process, is that if the customer don't have the enough balance to purchase the pack, we offered them to do an online recharge. So if they select that, so we take them to the payment gateway, where they recharge their phone number, and the payment gateway sends us a successful recharge action. And based on receiving that action, we again try to activate that particular pack to this phone number. That is the Flexi Plan module. Another self-care module is the online recharge, where user can put in their phone number and the particular amount they want to recharge. And based on the amount, we show them that with this particular figure, you can also bit more Dhaka, you can also activate a particular pack, which may be 350 MB of data or 15 minutes of talk time. So there's an upsell option. And also there's another option called the trigger recharge. Like, we have very few specific amount for which a particular pack is activated. Like, if you recharge 13 Dhaka, and it will activate 250 MB of data. After creating these self-care modules, we also developed an e-commerce module, which is a full-fledged e-commerce module considering not only the purchase journey from the customer side. After a successful order, we built separate dashboards for delivery partners, for inventory management team, for customer support, for the finance, and also for the site admin. It's like whenever an order is placed, in the customer dashboard, there's a certain notification received, and based on that notification, they call the customer to check whether it's a valid order or not. They check their address and also some landmarks if possible. And once that is done, it goes to the delivery partner dashboard and also to the inventory dashboard that this order has to be dispatched. And also the delivery partners needs to know that this product needs to be collected and delivered. So this collection is done once a day. So the delivery partners exports all the order details for that particular day and goes to the inventory team and collects the product and updates the status that this is dispatched. And once they got that, they redistribute the entire order package into particular orders, and they deliver to the customer's doorstep and then update the orders that it is delivered. And between all that steps, we send SMS notification for each steps whenever it is completed. And the finance dashboard, we have particular charts for the finance team to show them that which area of the country has done what, how much sales, and how generated how much revenue, these sort of things. And site admin can update the content of the dashboard, content of the website, in terms of the phone images, details, the freebies they are getting with this order, with this particular phone. This is it. Any questions? Yeah, sure, please.
I'm interested to which stack you use to communicate with other figure, like when you send a message to require the payment. Mm-hmm. For the recharge.
Yeah.
Which technologies, which figure, if it, all the user of the figure are in your stack, or there are other companies?
There are other companies or the stakeholders. Like,
yes.
We provide the UI to the customer for the recharge, where they put in their number and the amount. Then we take them to the payment gateway to put in their credit card information or the payment details. Once that is done, the payment gateway vendor sends information to the internal system, the CRM of the telco, and they recharge the number and they send feedback back to the payment gateway. Like, that is done. And once they got that, they return back to the website and we show them the success page, okay, that recharge has been done. Any more questions? No. Thank you very much.